Good evening, teacher.
Guys, good evening. Hiba, Hamad, how are you guys?
Evening.
Okay.
Thanks,
And you?
I'm okay. Thank you for asking. We have to
Good
wait for
evening.
you. Good evening, Hamad. How are you?
I'm good. What about you?
I'm good. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
We have to wait for your friends to come. Yeah, maybe 2 or 3 minutes maximum. So let's wait for them.
Good evening.
Guys, good evening.
Good
Good
evening.
evening.
I hope that everyone is okay. I have to write your names. So we have Zainab.
Okay.
Ready?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm only writing your names. I'm ready.
Okay,
Hamad.
okay.
هبة رائد يا اوكي يس هبة
الدرس الماضي أخدته بس هيدا الدرس كنتوا بس عم تقروه؟
يا اولي ريدنج
أوكي.
and we have to complete today Hiba, and you have to read.
أوكي.
Yeah, okay. So guys, I think we have to complete reading the two passages that we have been trying to read, which were about the flight and the first man on the moon. Okay, let me share my screen because now it's enough. I cannot wait for your friends just to come for a long period of time. Okay, so let me share the screen and let's complete. I know, guys, that I promised you to upload the videos to the channel. I couldn't this week, but absolutely I can at the end of this week just to upload the two lessons. So please forgive me. Okay, let me open the book and let's complete. So this is level two. I think someone is coming. No, no one. Okay. Yes, someone is coming. Tagreed is coming. Let me write her name. Okay, so let me share the screen and let's complete. Okay, okay, okay. I think, guys, we have started reading these two passages that I told you that the first passage is about the flight and the second one is about the first man on the moon. I think Dana is coming. Absolutely, I have to write her name. Okay. I remember, guys, that Ra'id, Tagreed, Hiba didn't read. Absolutely, they have to read because, as I told you guys, I'm grading you in the class. Okay. Right, can you hear me? Let me make a little zoom in.
Yes, I can.
Yeah, please, I'm right. You have to read. Okay, let me make a little zoom in. I think Jamila is coming. Let me write her name. Okay, can you please start reading the first text, Amraid?
Okay.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you, God. Okay, so if you're ready, I'm right. Please start reading.
Okay. On July 25, 1909, a Frenchman, Louis Blériot, became the first man to complete an air journey when he flew from Calais in the north of France to Dover in the south of England. Blériot's flight amazed the whole of Europe. People thought that such a journey was impossible. The flight wasn't easy. Mr. Blériot is a 37-year-old engineer, couldn't swim, so he didn't want to come down in the channel. He couldn't walk very very well because of an injury. An
Injury.
injury to his leg, and he didn't have a compass. On the morning of the 25th, he took off at 4:30 from a field at the edge of a cliff. It took 37 minutes to complete the 22-mile journey. The plane flew at 40 miles per hour at an altitude
Altitude, yes.
of 250 feet. Everything went well until he flew into fog. I continued flying for 10 minutes, but I couldn't see the land, only the sky and the sea. It was the most dangerous part of the flight. I wasn't worried about the machine. It flew beautifully. Finally, I saw the land. He told reporters landing in England. When he got to Dover, he saw a French journalist waving a flag. He cut the engine at 60 feet and crashed into a field. The news quickly went round the world, and Mr. Blériot's flight was celebrated in London and Paris. He won a prize of £1,000. The crossing was the start of modern aviation, said Louis Blériot, the grandson of the pioneer.
Okay, thank you so much, Amraed. You have a good reading skill. Okay, can you read this word again, please, Amraed?
Journey.
Exactly. And this word?
Amazed.
Okay. Guys, you're still saying the E sound if the verb is in the simple past. Please, Amraed, the E sound should not be pronounced. You have to say amazed. Okay. So,
okay.
Exactly. It is amazed. But not amazed. Okay, can you read this word?
Okay, amazed.
Exactly. This word is?
Injury.
Injury, exactly. And this date is?
25th.
25th.
Okay.
Yeah, because 25, guys, is the cardinal number, but 25th is the ordinal number. So please, this is ordinal, not cardinal. So you have to say 25th. Okay, Raed?
Okay.
Can you read it again, please?
25th.
Exactly. Okay. And what about this word again?
Crushed.
Yes, crash. Thank you so much. I'm right. Again, you have a good reading skill. Tagreed, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Please, I need you to read the second text, which about the first man on the moon. Can you see the text?
Now I see it.
Okay. So if you see it, please start reading.
Okay. On 16 July 1969 at 9:30 in the morning, Apollo 11 lifted off from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. There were three astronauts, Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins. The enormous rocket took 3 days to complete the 250,000 miles to the moon, traveling at 6 miles per second, 21,060 miles an hour. Then it circled the moon 30 times, giving time to prepare for the landing. The lunar landing. The lunar module landed on a part of the moon called the Sea of Tranquility at 8:17 in the evening on 20 July. And it was time for the astronauts to rest, but they were too excited to sleep. At 3 in the morning on July 21, Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the moon. 600 million people all over the world watched on TV as Armstrong took his first steps. He said the famous words, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind." Walking on the moon, Armstrong and Aldrin spent 2.5 hours walking on the moon. They collected samples and set up scientific equipment. Finally, they put up a US flag. After 22 hours on the moon, the lunar module lifted off and flew up to join the rocket. Then that took them back to Earth. They left an inscription: "Here, men from the planet Earth first set foot upon the moon, July 1969. We came in peace for all mankind. The flight was the beginning of man's exploration of space."
Amazing! Thank you so much, Tagreed. You have a good reading skill. Okay. Can you read this word again, Tagreed?
Yes.
Can you say it again? Because
enormous.
Enormous, amazing. And what about this number?
600.
600, amazing. Okay, what about this word?
Tranquility.
Yes, and this date is
20 July.
Okay, guys, you're still saying 20. 20 July, guys, is a cardinal number. And I told you that if you want to use numbers with dates, you have to say the 20th of July or July the 20th. Okay, I agreed.
Okay.
Again,
okay.
You still have, guys, that problem of saying the date correctly. If you want to say the date, you have to use ordinal numbers, not cardinal. So absolutely, if I want to read this date, I have to say the 20th of July. I cannot say 20 July, it is wrong. That's it. Thank you so much, Abdagrid. I have to confess that you are a good reader. Hiba, can you hear me?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, I think you are the last one. So, can you read the first text, please?
Okay. Only July 25, 1909, a Frenchman, Louis Albert Lertlo, became the first man to complete an air journey when he flew from Calaisia in the north of France to Dover in the south of England.
It is what?
France?
France, exactly. Or France, it
French.
is, but not with she, because French
okay.
is Farency, so it is not French, but
French.
France.
France to Dover in the south of England. Lertrore's flight amazed the whole of Europe. People thought that such a journey was impossible. The flight wasn't easy. Mr. Blériot, a 37-year-old engineer, couldn't swim, so he didn't want to come down in the channel. He couldn't walk very well because of an injury to his leg, and he didn't have compass. On the morning of the 25th, he took off at 4:30 from a field at the edge of a cliff. It took 37 minutes to complete the 22-mile journey. The plane flew at 40 miles.
Lane, exactly. It is
plane,
not.
plane flew at 40 miles per hour
it's mile. Guys, meal. Guys, لاحظوا أحيانا أنه تغيير بسيط بالساوند بيؤدي لاختلاف المعنى. يعني هبة، إذا بدك تقرأي هيدي الورد عن جديد، كيف بتقرأيها؟
field.
failed. Okay guys، إذا بدي أقول failed، failed تعني فشل. This is fail، يفشل. بينما failed، فشل. So it is not failed. This is field.
Field.
ونفس الشيء بالبلان. بلان من دون إي تعني خطة، بس أكيد مع إي المفروض الفوز بلين. And meal، meal تعني وجبة. اللي عم بيقول meal، guys meal تعني وجبة، وأكيد في فرق كبير بين meal كوجبة ومايل. فجايز أكيد لازم ننتبه، لأنه أحيانا خطأ بسيط بالبرونانسيشن بيؤدي لإساءة الفهم، وبالأخص إذا كان عم نحكي مع شخص لغته الإنجليزية مش الأم. أوكي you can complete.
Mile per hour at an altitude of altitude of 2,250 feet. Everything went well until he flew into fog. I continued flying for 10 minutes, but I couldn't see the land, only the sky and the sea. I was the most dangerous part of the flight. I wasn't worried about the machine. It flew beautifully. Finally, finally, I saw the land, he told reporters, landing in England. When he got to Dover, he saw a French journalist waving a flag. He cut the engine at 60 feet and crashed into a field. Crashed
without the sound. Exactly.
The news quite quickly went round the world, and Mr. Pilatos felt was celebrated in London and Paris
Celebrated.
celebrated in London and Paris. He won a bid of 1,000
1,000 what?
euros. Pounds.
This is euro,
Pounds.
guys. Yeah, this is
Okay,
euro.
okay, okay. Okay, pounds.
Exactly.
Zach Rushing was the start of modern aviation.
Aviation.
St. Louis. Aviation. St. Louis Billiot, the grandson of the pioneer.
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 Okay, thank you so much, Hiba. You are a good reader. طبعا جايز يمكن هتسألوني ليش أنا مش عم أصلح النيمز لفظ النيمز النيمز جايز النيمز جايز ما إلى رول فأكيد كل العالم تخطئ بلفظ الأسماء بسبب اختلاف الثقافات فالاسم حتى النيتيف سبيكرز أحيانا بيخطئوا بلفظ الاسم أو اسم مكان so because we don't have a rule okay can you read this word again Hiba
Friends.
Exactly. This word is?
Wall.
It's hole.
Hole.
Wall, this is wall. Wall تعني جدار.
Hole.
So
Okay.
this is hole. Can you read this word?
Compass.
Compass, exactly. What about this word?
Injury.
Yes, and this word is?
Pill.
Field, thank you so much. What about this word?
Meal.
No.
Meal.
Meal is wrong. So I have to say?
Meal.
Mile.
Mile. Okay,
Yes.
okay.
And this word is?
Aya.
This word?
Okay. Engine.
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 Engine تعني محرك and this word is
plane
plane thank you what about this word
prize
prize thank you prize تعني جائزة what about this word
celebrated
celebrated exactly celebrated احتفل so this is it guys the meaning of altitude is ارتفاع so this is it thank you so much Hiba Thank you, guys. You notice, guys, that the texts on level 2 are becoming a little harder. So please, you have to be careful. Okay. Now it is the time to solve the following questions. Let me open the book twice just to be able to read the text and to give me the answer. So let
فينا
me...
أنا ما جربت أقرأ
who is that?
غادي ما
غادي. Okay, let me write your name. Wait. Yeah, if you didn't read, absolutely you have to. Okay, let me make it full screen again. And I need you ready to read the second passage, please, which is about the first man on the moon.
بلش اقرا
Police.
Only 16 July 1969 at 9:30 in the morning Apollo 11 lifted off from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida there were three astronauts Neil Armstrong,
Neil Armstrong.
Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michelle Collins. The enormous rocket took the 3 days to complete the 250,000 miles to the moon, traveling at 6 miles per second. Twenty-one six hundred miles an hour. Then it circulates the moon 13 times, giving time to prepare for the landing.
Okay, can you complete? Already, please.
The lunar landing. The lunar module landed on the part of the moon called the Sea of Tranquil at 8:17 in the evening on 20 July. It was time for the Armstrong to rest, but they were to existed to sleep at 30 in the morning on July 21. Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the moon. 600 million people on all over the world watched on TV as Armstrong took his first step. He said that the famous work, that famous work, that's on a small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Walking on the moon, Armstrong and Aldrin spent 2.5 hours walking at the moon. They collect samples and set up scientific equipment. Finally, they put up a US flag at 22 hours on the moon. The Lion model lifted off and flew up to join to rocket the talk them back to Earth. They left an inscription, her remain from the planet Earth first set foot up on the moon, July 1969. We come in space for all making men. The flight was the beginning of man's exploration of space.
Okay, thank you so much, Amghadi. Guys, again, sometimes maybe you face a word, this word you cannot maybe read, or it is little long. دائما guys, لما يكون عنا word, هيدي الword صعب انه نقرأه, لازم نقسم الword لسيلابلز. Syllables تعني مقطع لفظي. فلاحظوا guys, عندي man كone word, وkind. So kind as one word, and man as one word. So I have to say man alone, kind alone. Then I have to say them as one word. It is mankind. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Okay, so can you please read this word?
The.
Okay, guys, the, it is in the Arabic culture. It is the. Okay, ready?
Yeah, the.
أوكي طبعا غادي أنا حأفهمك لما تقول زي لأنه ثقافتنا وحدة وعايشين ببلد واحد بس أكيد إذا بدك تحكي مع شخص من أستراليا أو من كندا أكيد الثقافات لأنه مختلفة مش حيفهم عليك لما تقول زي فجايز لازم نلفظ الورد أكيد مثل ما هي مكتوبة فلازم أقول ذا أوكي غادي
okay.
so I have here I have to say what
There.
Exactly. What about this name?
ميشيل.
Okay, guys. برجع بقول ميشيل بثقافتنا، بس بثقافة الغرب ما في ميشيل. عنا مايكل.
اوكي
And this word is
دايز
days. Okay. لاحظت غدي
سودان.
إنه wait. خلال الريدنج الاس اس الجمع انت مش عم تلفظه. طبعا اس الجمع كتير مهم انه نلفظها جايز. اذا ما لفظنا اس الجمع المجتمع حيفكر انه نحن عم نستخدم السنجولر، فاكيد اي اس بنهاية الورد المفروض انه تلفظ بوضوح. بعرف انه باللغة الفرنسية احيانا في نهايات حروف لا تلفظ، بس اكيد جايز كل لغة إلها رولز بتخصها. Please don't mix between languages. Can you read this word?
Second.
Okay, this is K, ready. Second.
Yes, second.
Exactly. What about this word?
Circular.
Okay. أنا guys عم لاحظ إنه بعد عم نعاني من مشكلة الـ E sound. فالمفروض guys إنه نخصص وقت منيح لحتى نعمل practice على الـ E sound. Okay. جايز البرونسيشن كتير مهم بالإنجليش، وأكيد في فرق كبير أنا لما أقول circled، وأكيد في فرق لما أقول circled. Okay, let's practice the endings of some verbs, especially if we have S and ED. طبعا جايز S أكيد هي بالسيمبل بريزنت، ED is in the simple past. هيدي المشكلة جايز بيعانوا منها من تقريباً 90% من الطلاب، مش ما بيقدر يلفظ نهايات الحروف، بالأخص إذا كانت ED or maybe S. So now, what if I have any verb ends with ED, like circled, and what if the verb ends with S? What shall I do? Okay. Now, guys, listen carefully because this lesson is really important to you. So we have two endings. The first ending is S and the second ending is ED. Okay, let's discuss the first ending. Okay, guys, لاحظوا عندي ثلاثة أفعال. وبثلاثة أفعال بينتهوا بالED، بس كل فعل إلو نهاية تختلف عن الفعل الثاني. أوكي، خليني أقرأ الأفعال ونلاحظ جايز كيف في اختلاف بالإندينجز إذا كان عندي ED. Notice here guys I have to say missed. أنا ببساطة أول شيء حذفت الـ E sound واستبدلت الـ D بـ T. So missed. Missed. هاي أول verb. Verb 2 is played. كمان رجعنا حذفنا الـ E sound ولفظنا فقط الـ D. The third verb is wanted. أما بالverb 3 لفظت الـ E sound ولفظت الـ D sound. طب ليه يعني أول فعل أنا حذفت الـ E واستبدلت الـ D بـ T، وليش الفعل number 2 حذفت الـ E وحافظت على الـ D sound، أما الفعل number 3 حافظت على الـ E sound وعلى D sound. Please guys again listen carefully because I will not repeat this lesson twice. Now let's listen to rule number one. Rule number one is saying if any sound, if any verb, any word, this word ends with T or maybe D, you have to pronounce the ED. Let's take this example. Notice I have want in the simple present, and in the simple past, it becomes wanted. So I said wanted because the verb ends with T, and any verb ends with T. If you want to add ED, you have to pronounce the E sound with D sound. So want, wanted. Chat, chatted. Again, notice the verb ends with T. Because of that, I pronounced the E sound with D sound. The third verb is repeat. Repeat in the simple present. In the past, it becomes repeated. Again, I said the E sound because the verb ends with what? With T. Now the next verbs we have need in the simple present. In the past, it becomes needed. Again, I said needed. I pronounce the E sound with D sound because the verb ends with D. This is it. The next verb we have attend. In the past, it becomes attended. Again, I pronounced E with D because the verb ends with D. Finally, we have recede. Recede, the verb ends with D. So I have to say receded because the verb ends with D sound. Is rule number one clear, guys?
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Dana, can you read the words, please?
Yes. Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Amazing. Thank you. Zainab, can you read the word, please? All the words.
Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Amazing. Thank you. What about you, Ghadi?
Yes. Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Please, Mohammed, if you can hear us.
Yes, I can.
Please.
Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Amazing. Thank you. Please, Amhiba, can you read them?
Yes. Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Amazing. Thank you. What about you, Raed?
Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Okay, thank you so much. Please, Amtagreed.
Yes. Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Thank you so much. Please, Jamila.
Yes, teacher. Wanted, needed, chatted, attended, repeated, receded.
That's amazing. Thank you. Please, finally, Nahil.
Wanted, chatted, repeated, needed, attended, receded.
Okay, that's amazing. So please, guys, do not forget rule number one. Any word ends with T sound, D sound, the E with D shall be pronounced. Now, let's listen to rule number two. Rule number two is saying any word, this word ends with voiceless sound. The meaning of voiceless, لا صوتي. لا يحوي على صوت. It is silent or voiceless. Okay. Besides T, okay. Now I have to pronounce it as T. The D should be replaced with T. And I don't pronounce the E sound at all. Let me give you an example. Notice I have miss. Miss, I have to say missed. So I deleted the E with D. Let me tell you why. Because the S is voiceless, not voiced. So any word ends with voiceless sounds, okay, I have to delete the E sound and I have to replace the D with T. طبعا guys, الS هو voiceless. يعني ما عندي صوت. لما أقول voiceless guys, يعني الحنجرة لا تتحرك. إذا منجرب منقول S, منلاحظ الحنجرة ما في, نحن منسميها vibration, يلي هي الارتجاج, وأكيد الارتجاج بيصير بالحنجرة, وفقط الحنجرة بتلفظ الحروف الصوتية فقط. I mean voiced. So S is voiceless. فمعناها أي...
سوري قطعتك, بس في حروف محددة هني voiceless.